Hey everybody. Welcome back to another version of The Death of Karen Allen. Last week we finally found the fabled magazine that allowed her to build stick traps, which should allow her to make some delicious meals out of dead birds. That was a new button. Dismantle, eh? All right, I'm game. Seem to be anything I can dismantle. I see. Interesting, though. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these should be 5. Hey, Greg. One second, I'll see if I can fix that. There, how's that? I'm just doing some renovation. I don't like this color. I need to find gravel. I thought this was gravel, but apparently it's just like a cement driveway. I'm wondering if grass will start growing on here if I wait long enough. Interesting. I wonder if I have another dirt bag. I can speed this up. Probably. That sounds like the kind of thing that I would have grabbed. Worms keep escaping from my traps. in the old foodstuffs. Good thing I've almost got my infinite potato farm going. Yeah, but I have it growing in, here, I'll show you when I'm done this load of dirt. Oh, look at that. New grass is growing on the dirt. At least I think that's what that is. Unless I just poured that on top of something like this. So, these are phase one, these are phase two, or these are phase five? Oh, they're on phase six now, which means I need to plant more potatoes. So I have it so that at any given time there's every single type of phase of potatoes. Rest, hurry up. Come on in. Do a quick perimeter search. Yeah, I didn't do the math either. I just assumed that I was right. I can actually start harvesting these ones, but I want to wait until they're seeded, so. Don't. Ooh. I got a bird. Where is it? Yeah, bird. Sweet, I have a dead bird. I can't wait. I'm gonna eat some dead bird once I'm done cleaning up all these zombies. Road zombies. Look at that, my first trapping experience. Well, from things that are actual food and not just rats. That's the plan. Probably a stir-fry. Stir-fry is better than stew. In fact, I'm gonna cheat. I'm gonna take one of these plants. Because I think I have too many anyways. So that I can actually get that potato meat stew going right now. She deserves it. She's got enough food to go for a little while. And I can refill my water supplies at the same time. She's had interaction with human-like things. She's probably pretty nuts, though, you're right. It's a good question. I can only create stir fries from potatoes. I can't create it from dead birds. Oh, wait, there we go. Butcher bird. Enough for one, but look at that hunger from the bird meat and potato stir fry. Oh yeah. Okay, I should have been doing that before previously as well. I didn't realize I could butcher the rats, because I didn't happen to have a knife in my inventory the first time I did that. Fresh butchered rat. My favorite. Yep, never, you should never go hungry. Right, it's a two tree branch kind of thing. Actually, let's figure out exactly what it does. That way I can just put in the right amount of fuel. So, one tree branch. And two twigs. Burning. Oh, I guess it was partially cooked before, so it kept that. Karen's gotta get her schedule back on schedule. Well, it's more useful to get work done during the day. It's easier to see. So it's more of a light-based sleep schedule than anything else, really. Cool, she's gaining weight. That's good. Yeah, well, she needed to survive, okay? It was either that or die. Yeah, I guess that's true. Perfect time to wake up. Have some roasted vegetables. Get to work with my digging plans. Check my traps. Man, I'm going through worms fast. Birds just keep taking all my worms. Does the success rate go up higher as you level up your trapping? Do you know? Whatever, new traps are still cool. I like that this, I have a shovel now and I don't need a spade anymore. I've upgraded my farming techniques. Karen's badass, that's how. Nah, they're probably all crumbly now. It's been like 3 months. 4 months. I'm leaving this part like that so that I can see that my stick pile right there. Otherwise, it'll blend in with the dirt. Where's my stick? I should throw these raw axes back in there. I don't need to hold on to them. She's still feeble, though. Almost level 4 strength. Maybe she'll lose feeble then. She's also prone to illness. Oh, but she's fit now. Was she always fit? She's apparently overweight. Apparently Karen got fat after eating all those chips. Maybe my meals are too good now. She's not used to eating so well that she started to put on the weight because her body thinks that she's in a period of sustenance so that she should maintain it. That's funny. I decided that Karen's bedtime is going to be 2200. I still got to finish building that extra outer wall around my house. That'll take a while. I got bored with doing that because log walls take so much time to move. At least Karen doesn't care when she gets wet. That's a nice advantage of being a former scout. Logs are heavy. Ah, I was a pretty feeble scout back when I was a scout. It's funny because dirtbag is an insult, but right now dirtbags are pretty useful because, like, you know, you can, like, build rooftop gardens and stuff. Not that I have a rooftop garden. I can't even build stairs yet. Let's see, does this give me 12 hours of sleep? Have I been up long enough? 9 hours. Alright, so 22 is not going to be a good time. I want to be getting up at 8 o'clock every day, so... let's try it at 2300. Or I could just go to bed at midnight and just knock the sleep down to 8 hours. 9. 11 o'clock's a good bedtime for 9 hours of sleep. Karen was an electrician. So, she was an electrician who's a former scout. So she was always kind of like what would be considered a, like, you know, one of those girls who is one of the guys. Didn't really take shit from anybody. Wasn't super strong though. Even after being a scout, being one of the only girls in the scout crew, she often tricked the other guys into carrying her bags and shit for her. Nice. All three of these ones have birds in them. She was a bit lazy, yeah. As if you get 200 experience for potatoes. Well, she always liked fires. She was good at lighting fires. She had a pretty intense attitude of, even though she made guys carry her bags for her, she didn't like, it wasn't like the full bag, it was just a little bit, you know? She was somebody who would take advantage of the situation if she could. She's super smart, though. She didn't need help with her going through electrician school. Although that's been less useful here. She hasn't made any traps. But she still has that same survivor's instinct. You know, to be a girl in a fairly male-dominated industry is... you know, you gotta have a certain attitude to do that. Alright. Where's my birds? Where's my birds at? Okay. Add tree branch and two twigs. Well, I don't think her troop leader would have thought that she would have been this good of a survivor, but... Salt and peppers for the meat dishes. Too bad you can't make your own recipes. Like, automatically add these things. Instead of having to add all the individual things. Actually, I'm gonna try that. What happens if I rename this as... meat and veg roasted. Meat and veg fry. I don't know. Nope. Yeah, that would be pretty funny. They'd be begging to get into Karen's sweet ass fort. Because it'll be pretty crazy by then. Alright, let's light this fire up. Now let's see if my two twigs assumption was correct. I'm gonna need more twigs. I'm running low on my stockpile. I'll have to do some scavenging. Maybe tomorrow. Once I've done that. It's only gonna take two more. Yeah, well, the NPC edition's probably a ways away still. Yep, that's true. Alright, looks like two twigs is enough to get them cooked. I'll try one twig next time. How long have I been streaming for? Hour and 5 minutes. Alright, I'm gonna just finish up filling in that sand. Let's see, how much of this can I eat? Eat 1/4? Eat 1/4 because I don't want to get her any fatter than she is. Well, I was pretty hungry, so there we go. Yeah, I have faith in the Indie Stone. They're good dudes. And a girl. When they actually release NPCs, it's going to be pretty cool. Me and my friends have been planning on playing a multiplayer game at some point. That might be fun. We're gonna, like, turn the difficulty way up and stuff. hadn't really thought about it. It was just something that we were going to do for fun. It was probably just going to be a one-off. We don't have a lot of time, so if anything, it would be... I could record and stream the whole thing, and then just break it up into several different parts to upload. I wouldn't be hosting it. I've got enough DL speed, it's just that I don't have a lot of upload speed, so as long as I'm not hosting, it should be okay. In theory. But yeah, it might not be a good idea to stream. Maybe I'll just record it. I can record without streaming and then just post it to YouTube. I can't wait to get fiber. Then I can stream the other games I play too. I'm curious as to, once I get to level 10 in farming, if I'll still be getting farming experience when I harvest my stuff. Nobody's as good as me at PZ. No, my friends haven't really played. That's what's going to make it interesting. It'll be me running around like a pro and them dying every few minutes. I mean, there might be somebody else that's as good as Project Zomboid as me, but... But nobody's, I just don't know. It's not like there's a competition or anything. I was running the leaderboards a while back, but those don't really tell you skill. Well, thank you, Grig. If only more people would watch my streams, I'd feel more popular. I used to have a lot of people watching my videos back in the day, but... Maybe Project Zomboid has fallen out of vogue or something. Oh, neat. If I take the dirt out from underneath a bush and stuff, it doesn't grow. It just goes away. That's interesting. I should do that around my entrances and exits. Get rid of all the plants. I have two people watching right now. I think one of them's probably me. I have it opened another window. Yeah, it's just me and you right now. I have my Twitch dashboard up in on my browser. I think once it gets released, it'll be good. Once they're out of the betas. At least Karen's been pretty happy with this food that she's been eating lately. Oh yeah? Okay. Neat. I didn't know that. I didn't see... What the... Get out of here, zombie. You really think you can mess with me? Don't you know who I am? Like, I'm not even gonna use a weapon on you. Silly zombie. Make sure there's nobody else around. All over already. Yeah. Ooh, vitamins. Ching. Lighter in my hand. That's kind of neat. No, turn off. I hit F. Unequip. There we go. I play Stellaris, a lot of DOTA, Dota 2, I guess it's technically called nowadays. I don't really stream anything else. I play a really good Pugna in DOTA. Probably the best. Well, one of the best. Oh no, Taryn, it's half an hour past your bedtime. What are you doing? Yeah, I played Frozen Synapse a while back too. But that was only on YouTube because they had that sweet easy upload feature, which was fun. ...11 hours? Nope. You only get 8 hours of sleep, it's midnight. Sorry, Karen. Gotta keep your sleep schedule correct. Alright, so that's that done. Put your sandbags back in your box. Have yourself a snack. No, don't eat all of it. One quarter. There we go. Check out your stats. Get still fat. Getting fatter. Can't really control that. That's more of a balance change. Okay. Alright, Karen. Good job. You're ready to go. Thanks for watching, Greg. I'll see you again next week. Or if you're not here, then I'll just stream by myself. It's been a pleasure. See you next time. Yeah, she definitely gained some weight pretty quick. Alright, see ya.